Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. With the release of Flame 2019, one of the major enhancements is a new task-based environment that brings a new level of grading and VFX integration directly into the timeline. So all your Timeline VFX and Grading toolsets are in one place, with full navigational tools and access to the rich Flame toolset. This will allow you to work faster than ever before, develop and iterate a shot or multiple shots, and there are a bunch of new tools for sophisticated image treatments such as color grading, beauty retouching, and creative look effects. This is all integrated within Flame's core keying, masking, and tracking systems. This environment is known as Effects, and it also has its own task-based tab alongside MediaHub, Conform, Timeline, Batch, and Tools. This video serves as a general overview of effects to get you started, and future videos will take a deep dive into specific features and workflows. Let's start at the very beginning with a single track timeline, and we'll introduce more editorial complexity at a later stage. You can use your own media to follow along. So you could have conformed the sequence from another application, or used Flame's editing toolset to cut this piece together. Either way, at some point, you will want to start applying VFX or grading to the edit. So move the positioner onto a shot you want to affect. You can select it, but if you don't, it's not a problem either. The segment will be implicitly selected based on the positioner's location, as well as the small focus point, which always sits across the positioner. The positioner is your point in time, and the focus point indicates what track you are working on. This will become more important with multi-track timelines. Now you can access the effects environment simply by clicking the Effects tab or press space F4. Since you did not specify a particular timeline effects, the default starting point of the effects environment is your integrated grading. So if you need to start grading straight away, you don't have to add any timeline effects. Just switch to the effects environment and off you go. To return to the timeline, you can click the Timeline tab, press the Exit button, or press the Escape keyboard shortcut. Just choose the option that works best for you. Now, if you did want to add a timeline effects to a segment before going into the effects environment, you would call up the effects ribbon, either with the button or press Control Tab, and choose your timeline effects. You have your first level controls in the effects toolbar for quick adjustments without leaving the timeline view. To access all the controls of the timeline effects, you could click the effects tab, but you can also click the editor button, the timeline effects in the effects pipeline, or simply double click on the segment. Any of these actions will bring you back into the effects environment. So it's now one environment for all the timeline effects. However, if you want to do node compositing in the timeline with batch effects, this is a completely different environment and is not accessible when you're in the effects view. If you call up the effects ribbon by clicking the effects button or control tab, these options are grayed out. If you return to the timeline and call up the effects ribbon again, these options are now active. The timeline effects pipeline can be converted into a node graph, but it has to be done at the timeline level by design. Now let's take a look at the standard layout of the effects environment. Delete the timeline effects either by gesturally dragging it to the bottom of the UI or through the contextual menu. So no timeline effects are applied to this segment. Switch over to the effects environment. Now the effects interface can be divided in 5 sections. Firstly, you have the viewer. This can show your images, scopes, schematics, and storyboard. Beneath that, you have the storyboard reel. This is an interactive picture-based representation of the timeline, which allows you to navigate, filter, and sort your shots in a variety of ways. So it's really easy to move between the different shots in one environment. Underneath the storyboard reel, you have the effects pipeline, which shows the effects pipeline for the current segment. You can use this to navigate the timeline effects, copy them, create presets, delete them, as well as syncing timeline effects using connected segments and the connected Conform workflow. You can also access the effects ribbon via this area. As a tip, if you wanted to hide the effects bar, just press Space Tab. The same keyboard shortcut will bring it back. The largest section at the bottom of the interface gives you the player controls, animation curves, as well as the various creative tools depending on which timeline effects you're using. The default state of the effects environment uses the image timeline effects, which consists of integrated grading, known as the master grade, and selective tools for image isolation. The image toolset can also work with other VFX and look development shaders, so it's incredibly powerful and fast. This will be covered in much greater detail in future videos. Finally, the last section to cover is the media panel. In this situation, the media panel acts as an area to store all your grading and effects settings. They are stored as effects clips within the structure of the workspace, making it easy to organize, share, and save. They can also be backed up as part of an archive at the end of the production. If you want more space for your viewer section, you can hide the media panel using the drop-down menu, or hold Control and swipe it away. The same gesture would bring it back. So those are the general areas of the effects environment, but you can customize it to whatever task you're performing. For example, let's say you're doing a bit of grading. So you'll switch to a 2-up view with Alt 2 and use the contextual menu to enable the scopes. I am using the All preset, which has a variety of scopes. All of this can be configured through the contextual menus and scope settings. Once you're happy with the layout, you would click Selective 1 in the Viewer Heads-Up Display or HUD to call up the selective controls in the interface. As you navigate between the different shots in the storyboard, note that the layout is persistent, allowing you to jump between shots with your tools ready to start. Now, one very small but important detail is the color of the image timeline effects in the storyboard reel and in the effects pipeline. When you enter into the effects environment without applying a timeline effects with the effects ribbon, the image timeline effects is on standby and not actually applied to the shot. This is indicated by the orange light. If you don't make any adjustments and just switch to different shots in the storyboard reel, the image timeline effects on the previous shots will just disappear. If we come back to our original shot and start making any changes, such as increasing the lift and an increase in saturation, the timeline effects turns blue, indicating it is now applied to the current shot. You can now scrub the result, play it back if you want, and you can even adjust settings during playback. Obviously, this is a very simple example, but the point I am making is the speed in which you can work in an integrated grading and VFX environment. You can easily move from one shot to another and apply grading, VFX, or both. Just to show you that it is possible, you can even select a shot or a multi-selection of shots and copy the timeline effects between them. You can then navigate to these shots and refine them further if needed. So switching back to the timeline view, you still have access to your editorial sequence with all the effects and grading applied through the effects environment. And at any time, you can always switch back to the tools via the effects tab and continue refining VFX grading and look development. Hopefully, this general introduction has given you enough to get started. And throughout the course of this series, you'll learn much more about storyboard navigation, filtering, sorting, contextual views, player controls, preset creation, and much more. There will also be additional in-depth videos on the image toolset and the HDR-capable master grade. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Remember to subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.